Hi everyone, Good Old Guitar School here. Last week I did a little video on how to play Ed Sheeran's Galway Girl, and what I thought I'd do today is just elaborate a little bit more on the strum pattern. So this is very simplified, but if you wanted to do a bit more through that chorus, this is a way you can do it. So you can pause this to write stuff down, and I'm going to add as we go. So you've got down, up, down, down, up, down, down. You've got to get the gaps in the right place so that it makes it a bit more clear. And you've got this little motif, which I'm going to just mark on here. This isn't a bar, okay, but it's just to make it clearer. So you do a down, and you've got this that repeats, up, down, down, up, down, down. Notice there's a slightly longer gap between those two downs, okay? Now, this covers the first two chords. So the first down is going to be E minor. Okay, now the trickiest bit, I think, is the fact that it changes chord on that last down there. So you get down, up, down, down, and that last down is where it changes chord. So down, down, up, down, 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 up, down, down. If you want to try it first without the change, that can make it easier, so you can just concentrate on the actual strum pattern. So that's going to go down, up, down, down, do the whole thing just on E minor, down, up, down, down, up, down, down, then all you've got to get is that G in the right place, and it all finishes the strum on the G. So down, you stay there, down, 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 up, down, down, up, down, 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 up, down, change. Then you just repeat it for the next two chords, D and C, down, up, down, change. Just do that a little bit slower as well. Down, up, down, down, up, down, 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 up, down, down, up, down, down. Now, those of you that want to take this a little bit further, what you can do is before the change, so I'm just going to make this really fat so you can see where this one sits. You can put a mute in, but it's still a strum, okay? So that down there, what you can do is, rather than when we did it last week with the tap, you're still strumming it. So normally we strum and we just let the pick go across the strings, but if I pick and let the back of my hand, so both these things are touching the strings, so I'm still doing it as if, so I don't lose the rhythm of the strum, but I'm just dampening the string with the back of my hand. So you get, you don't have to have that. So put it on that very last one as well, or just without, it's fine. I hope that all makes sense. If you've got any questions, send them along, but have fun with that. Bye bye.